No, you don't?
No.
Don't tell anybody that.
Just hold me.
Okay.
That'll make it better.
Hello, my lovelies out there. It's me, Cindy Sedman, here once again for another heaping helping of Game Show Gumbo. And yes, Game Show Gumbo. All we do is we give you the best highlights and game shows out through the week. We watch all of them so you don't have to. And we give it to you in this nice 20-minute bowlful. So, what's been going on? Well, as you know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And what we would like for you to do as Game Show Gumbo is take some time or some pocket change they have out of your day and donate it to some charities that are worthwhile, like your local oncology clinics or hospitals that deal with breast cancer or any cancer in general, and make those that are suffering's lives just a little bit easier as they suffer through this devastating disease. So, coming up on this wonderful edition of Game Show Gumbo, you know what we have? We have a very puzzling Survivor Tribal Council. We have relationship advice on Funny You Should Ask. And not only that, John Michael Higgins hits on Meredith Vieira.
You changed it. Now it's harder.
Look, dude, I don't want to know what power Meredith Vieira did to make it harder. More titillation on that front later. First up, Season 39 of Survivor, a.k.a. Island of the Idols, is insane right now, and especially the last episode. So let me set up this last tribal council for you. Krishma sliced her hand and was whining about it, and nobody cared, so she thinks she's on the bottom of the tribe. Vince gets sent to Island of the Idols, and while he's out there, Dave plans to blindside him by splitting the vote. He says this because everybody is there. So, really, I don't think anybody is going to want to be like, ooh, pin the three votes on me and put the five on Vince. Ooh, put it on me. So, Vince does get the immunity idol from Island of the Idols. Karishma gets more crap on her because on the third immunity challenge, she fails a puzzle again. This is the second time this has happened. Now, back at camp, Vince is saying, because Vince likes Karishma, okay, I want to save you, so let's put the votes on Tom. Let's get me and the girls, and we'll put all six votes on Tom. So, you have a potential boot of Tom, just for being a guy. You have Karishma for being a bit of an irritant and not very good at puzzles and losing immunity challenges. And Vince, just because he went to Island of the Idols. Confused? Well, let this tribal council voting clear everything.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so. Okay, I'll read the votes.
Oh my God.
First vote, Tom. Karishma. Three votes, Karishma. One vote, Tom. Vince. That's two votes, Vince. Vince, we're tied. Three votes, Vince. Three votes, Karishma. One vote, Tom. Vince, that's four votes, Vince. Three votes, Karishma. One vote left. Third person voted out. Vince, need to bring me a torch?
Vince is leaving with an idol in his pocket.
Vince, the tribe has spoken.
Good luck, all. Darkness.
Well, you may suck at puzzles, but you're really good at blindsides.
And yet another case of somebody not reading the room, and Vince goes home with an idol in his pocket. Well, off to the pile of Aubrey and everybody else. See you at the reunion, Vince. Wednesday on Survivor, Plan Z will come to effect as both tribes continue to figure out how to flush out idols and everything. Find out if they could do just that on Wednesday. There's an old saying that says cheaters never prosper, and one of the places that you hardly see any type of cheating whatsoever is on Family Feud. Well, in the last Celebrity Edition a week or so ago, Jeff Garland actually did just that. How, you ask? Well, let's let the clip and Anthony Anderson speak for itself.
Jeff, this is real simple. There's one answer left. If it's there, your team wins the game.
No!
If it's not there... Yeah. If it's not there, you're still alive. Can't discuss it, guys. When clowns get together,
did they just
what?
Cheat?
They cheated. I think they cheated. I saw them talking.
No, you came over. No.
He cheated.
You walked
over
there.
He cheated.
Get him, man.
America,
you saw that, right?
He cheated.
You saw that, right?
He cheated.
Get back. Get back. Get back.
They are correct.
Wow!
And I think we deserve an X.
What? Jeff!
No, I cheated. I cheated not knowing I was cheating. It doesn't matter.
Oh, my God! What a wonderful human being! Ladies and gentlemen, this has never happened in the history of Family Feud. Big hand for Jeff!
Hold on, Steve. The hell with giving him a hand, give him an X. He just admitted to cheating.
Yes.
In front of America.
An X.
Judges, what are we doing here?
Rewind the tape. You saw it.
Yeah, I saw it.
You saw
Roll
it.
The clip.
Okay, Steve, I'll take the X. I'll take the X. It's only right. I'll take the X.
Wow. Let's take an X.
Man, Anthony Anderson and Jeff Garland were really chirpy at one another in this show. Anyway, remember how I said about cheaters never prosper? I lied. Jeff won. Life is stupid sometimes, believe it or not. With the Celebrity Edition on hiatus, the civilian syndicated version is alive and well for your daily dose of answers that make Steve Harvey cringe on the inside but put a brave face on the out. Remember how on the last episode of Game Show Gumbo I pointed out that Price is Right has gone on for 48 seasons? Well, let me make this number a little bit more enticing. Just this past week, they celebrated 9,000 episodes on The Price is Right. 9,000! So, yes, we're obligated to do this, but because we can't use Akira Toriyama footage, so, are you ready? It's over 9,000! And the follow-up line to that is, producer?
What?
Exactly.
What, 9,000?
We're filming this in the morning, folks. Both of us are loopy. And you know what also helped out the show? It's contestant who actually went to 180 tapings. Even after he appeared on the Bob Barker version of The Price is Right. Well, here he is again, 180 taping days later on Drew's version.
You made it. Nice to see you, buddy. If you missed it earlier, Resendo just today broke the record for the most tapings attended. It's its 180th taping. You've been on with Bob, and now you're on with me. Congratulations, buddy. Nice to have you here. George, what do we got for him?
This had to be worth the wait. It's a new car! Yeah! It's the Mazda 3 Sport, featuring a 2.5-liter engine, 6-speed automatic transmission, and front-wheel drive. It's the Mazda 3!
Thank you, James. Mazda 3 Sport, playing a game called Pushover. Of course, I know you know the game. You're going to push these blocks till you get the 5 numbers you need in this blue area right here. 5 numbers in the price. Once you see the 5 numbers, stop pushing because you can't pull. Once it goes off the side, you're done with it, okay? Good luck, Crescendo. Go ahead. You're going to start out with 20,475. 20,475. 92,000. 19,204. Mazda 3 Sport, $21,920. Good luck, buddy. Remember, car plus $9,000 if he's right. You got it. Yeah! I've seen this guy at so many tapings since I've been here. He's been here 180 shows, just sitting in the audience. Good for him.
Bob Barker would have definitely called Rosendo a loyal friend and true after everything. And congrats on the car win, Rosendo. As you know, on the 9,000th edition of The Price Right, they had a special bonus where if you won your price of game, you got $9,000 cash as a bonus. So for Rosendo, that actually pays for the taxes on the car, the taxes on the cash, the taxes on his one-bid item to come up on stage, and leaves him enough for a full tank of gas. Still, congratulations, Rosendo. Next week, it's Big Money Week. Drew and the gang break every single penny bank they have and hopefully answer the question, will somebody finally win big on Blanco? Many fans of game shows and camp were saddened to hear about the loss of Rip Taylor this past weekend. He was a big star who appeared on a lot of shows in a guest role. He also appeared on a lot of game shows such as Match Game, Tattletales, Hollywood Squares, and he was the host of the crazy $1.98 beauty show from Chuck Barris Productions in 1978 to 1980. Game show fans remember him a lot from this very important highlight from Super Password involving recently passed Patty Dugastin and Bert Convy.
Testimony.
Perfect clue. That's the word.
Just what I always wanted, hair on my chest. I think.
I can't work under this kind of pressure.
excuse me, sir. I think I have something that belongs to you.
Testimony, we all know that.
What makes me feel old about this highlight is that everybody on the show is now gone. Well, I don't know about the contestants, but the announcer Gene Wooda died in the mid-90s. Bert Convy died in 1991. Patty Dugastin died in 2016 from sepsis. And as you know, Rip Taylor died over the course of the past last week, thanks to an epileptic seizure. We'll be back with more Game Show Gumbo right after this. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the Madhouse, guys, gals, and non-binary pals. John Michael Higgins and James Lynch expertly navigate their shows In America Says and Hollywood Game Night, respectively. But here's a question that I've always wondered. Does hosting a game show give you special powers that you could do throughout your day? Well, apparently both of them think so as they appeared on 25 Words or Less. And here, both of them sense a power, I guess, when it comes to Meredith Vieira? Question mark?
I don't like one of those, Meredith.
Oh, you don't?
I don't. Well,
me too. I'm having a problem with one.
But there's nothing I can do about that.
No. You can change it.
I can't change it.
She's got power. She's not that much.
No, I have that power.
Oh.
Wow.
I choose not to do it.
I choose, yes.
Prove it.
I don't have any power.
Oh, my gosh, Meredith, you changed it. Now it's harder. All right.
It's not. You just look at it long enough and it'll come to you.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
But
Janer?
Oh. All yours.
Oh, all right.
You know, John, if she actually had that power, I think we'd have more millionaires on the syndicated version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Just saying, actually. But we have a bonus clip for you, everyone. Now, Jay Lynch is really good on Hollywood Game Night, but as you know, there is a special rule about game show hosts, is that if you host a game show well, you kind of have to blow it a couple of times on other game shows. Here, Jay Lynch proves that rule.
7 words, 45 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now.
Fraternal, identical.
Twin.
9 words left.
Condo.
Apartment.
House.
8 words left.
Leaves, sweep.
Cool, clean.
Room, break. Got it.
6 words left.
JFK.
President.
Oh, no.
You know why? Yeah. What? Because the K stands for Kennedy.
Oh, shoot. Oh, God.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my heart.
Jane.
I'm so sorry, you guys.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We can't go back in time.
No,
at all?
You can't. Nope, you can't.
Oh.
But you can go forward and sit down.
I mean,
you
can do that, sure.
You can go forward and sit down, sure.
You know we still love you, Jane. Don't touch that fast forward button or any button on that remote when 25 words less is on your Fox stations. Please support the show and the friends that produce it and tune in. As we mentioned on the top of the show, it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and game shows are actually doing quite a few specials to help promote charitable causes and help uplift the people that are stricken by this disease. I'd like you to meet an important person, and I gotta read this off the script. Her name is Rachel, and she has battled cancer 4 times, believe it or not. 4 times. Breast cancer, I think ovarian cancer, colon cancer, and lung cancer. She's defeated 2, but currently is afflicted with 2 others. With the other 2. I think she defeated breast and ovarian, and is currently dealing with the others. Knowing that she doesn't have much time left on this earth, she is vowed to complete her bucket list, and Let's Make a Deal is one of those bucket list items. Here she is going for a car.
$200 to get that car.
We're going for number 2, and I'm so scared. Just hold me.
Okay.
That'll make it better.
All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Her group. Come on. Let's go. You did it.
I love you.
She did it. She did it. Come on, ladies. Come on.
We here at Game Show Gumbo congratulate you, Rachel. Now, hopefully, you'll be able to use that car to live out the rest of your bucket list. More deals are happening on the show all next week. See if it doesn't get zig and zagged away from Dancing Pants and the Zonkaroo. When you appear on a game show, there are some things that are okay to talk about yourself, like you have a good family, or you have a wonderful job, or you help save 30,000 lives. I mean, that last part can actually get you on Spin the Wheel and hopefully win a ton of money. But there are some things that you shouldn't say about yourself because they are extremely detrimental to your cause. Tony is a contestant who did just that on Funny You Should Ask. And this moment of what not to do and the ensuing aftermath is our game show Gumbo Clip of the Week.
Tony, what's your story, man?
I teach swim lessons to elementary school students, and I also played college football at Lawrence University in Wisconsin.
All right, a little ball in college, okay. Big baller. Tony, if you win cash today, what do you want to do?
Well, I've actually never spent more than like $20 on my girlfriend, so I'm thinking about buying
her. Hey, whoa.
A nice dinner, a nice present, and then maybe a little trip to Vegas where we can spend the rest of it.
Okay, alright. So slowly stepping up. I got it.
You know, he seems to be the type of guy that would treat his girlfriend to a dinner or a movie date. Now, let me rephrase that. That's dinner or a movie. You know, he would be like, okay, darling, we could go to this great movie, or we could go to this date, or go to this dinner. We can't do both. I gotta keep my reputation of being the ultimate cheapskate. And on that note, he really gets it from one of the most frivolous and also pretty much one of the most awesome things Byron Allen ever said on Funny You Should Ask.
Get to work, man. Put on that hard hat. Let's go. Louis Anderson, true or false? According to Tonic Vice, in Rhode Island, there is a cat that has accurately predicted the deaths of at least 50 people.
Yeah, that's why you shouldn't let the cats play in the ICU. I'm gonna say it's true.
I think you are wrong.
The correct answer? It's true. It's hard out there for you, brother. Still got time. Hang in there. Taylor, let's go back to you for some more money and Byron Allen one more time.
You know why this is happening, Tony? First of all, if you only spend less than $20 on your girlfriend, don't tell anybody that. Taylor, this is for you so we can get revenge on $20 Tony.
When it comes to spending money in a relationship, Byron's an expert. He would spend money on trips with his girlfriend, when it comes to a film festival, you know, nice jewelry, or even spending 9 figures on the Weather Channel when nobody would dare touch it. More hilarity and life lessons to be had next week. I'm still hoping for more jewels from Whitney Cummings or Bill Engvall. Well, that's going to wrap up this edition of Game Show Gumbo. I'd like to thank everybody who has watched, or will watch, or will continue watching. And if you really like the show to help support the show and maybe get us a set or something instead of this blue backdrop, become a member of our Patreon at patreon.com/gameshowgumbo. I'm Cindy Seidelman, and I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.